This video is going to show you how to use the Excel XLookup function. Our goal is going to be able to generate the picture we have here, where we have one table with sales information, and then we are able to look up information about the sales item in a different table. If you're working from the provided sample, you'll notice that all of these data are already organized as tables. If you're not, or working on a different example, you might need to do that first. Select your data, and then go to Format as Table, and pick a style to add to it. Once you do, it'll ask you if your table has headers, which is saying if the first row are titles. Usually you're gonna wanna make sure that's checked. The blue table covers items and the orange table covers sales. Our goal is gonna be to get information out of the blue table into the orange table. As we look at this, the first thing we need to figure out is where's the key information. In other words, what values can we use to link a sale with an item? Look at the first example on January 1st. Sales ID 1 happened on January 1st, and we sold item number A. We're going to look up in the blue table to find item A, which is the type key with a cost of $2.50. Now, I could manually do this, right? Come over here in the type lookup and write in the word key and the cost $2.50. However, the problem is that it's a lot of work to do that, and later on, if I change this cost to $3, this won't update over here on the right. XLookup takes three primary pieces of information or arguments. The first is the lookup value. This is a single cell in the orange table that we're going to try and find in the other table. In our example, to try and find key, you see that we have item number A, which we're going to use to look up in the item table. The biggest mistake people make at this point is choose an entire column. Try not to do that. Instead, click on a single value. If you get something called a spilled error, you probably click the entire column instead of the value. Once I have the item to look up, I'm going to go to the second argument, which is called the lookup array. This says, where do I find item A? Well, before, when I tried to link this manually, I looked in the first column, so I can see here A, B, and C. And at this time, now I'm going to pick up an array. In other words, the entire column. Now that I know what I want to look up, I have to pick what to return. To return, I'm going to pick up the type. I'm going to again select the array. Then I'm going to look up in column A and find that matching value and then get the value in column B. At this point, I've done, so I'm going to go ahead and close the parentheses, push enter, and see it fell all the way down. Now you can see I've got A, B, and C working properly. Item D does not work, however. It doesn't work because there's no item D over in the items table. Similarly, if I change one of these from B to say F, you'll see that now that one doesn't work either. The other good thing to know is that I can change a value over here in the items table, like from key to keys, and then all those values automatically get updated over here on the right. Let's do the second lookup. We're going to look at the same value, again, one cell. We're going to grab an array over on the left to look up in, and then grab a second array to return. Now, the nice thing about this is that they can be organized in any order. We could have cost on the left, items on the right, whatever we want, and it works fine. Typically in our class, we'll then create a pivot table. A pivot table is going to look at our new sales table and give us a summary of that information. The easiest way to do this is to go to Table Design, and we're going to click on our button that says Summarize with Pivot Table. Now you can just click OK, which will create a new tab, but I'm going to put this on the existing worksheet so we can see everything side by side. Now that I have my pivot table, I can drag and drop fields and start looking up some summary information. Let's start by looking at the items sold ID, and then just the count. Now, if you notice this, by default, any numeric value like ID is going to show you a sum, so I probably need to change that from sum into count. Now I can see how many sales I've made of A, B, C, and D. Now I may want to, instead of just showing A, B, or C, D, actually use the new columns I added here, the type lookup. So I'm going to take that out and add the type lookup. Now I can see you've got two keys, a one lock, one truck. I might even want to look at the sum of the cost lookup. Now, on this one, it automatically defaulted to count, so I'm going to change it back to sum. Now, as you can see, I've got a total sum of $6 for keys. Now, one thing about a pivot table is if you update the data, you have to tweak it a little bit. So let's say instead of the NA over here for D, I want to have it show that something's not found. I'm going to modify my lookup by adding a new argument. This is called if not found. So I'm going to put the words not found in quotes. Same thing for cost. If the cost is not found, I want it to be a question mark instead of an error. Now the pivot table hasn't automatically updated. To update, I need to click on it, go to Pivot Table Analyze, and then click on the Refresh button. Once I do this, I can now see my not found row label comes up, and I don't get an error message anymore in the sum. So hopefully this was a nice example of an easy XLookup. If you continue to the next video, then I'll show you a more complex example.